Hey, guys. So this is not a press release. And I'm going to say, I mean, some of the information that we're all sharing, I will share again. And so I think it's repetition is, conviction is in relationship to the amount of redundancy in the message. And so this is politics. I read that. Frederick Jameson. Yeah. It's one of my favorite quotes. Okay, so this is not a press release. They say that sometimes they will begin to destroy our park in November, and sometimes they say they will do it in December. They send representatives of the DDC to the community board meeting, and they promise they will post pictures of the construction plan before the meeting, and they do not do that. And they do not do that at the meeting. At the meeting, they say Esker might run a year longer than they had previously planned, and they say they will post pictures of the construction plan afterwards, and what they do then is post a link that doesn't go anywhere. Then they say next week, that's what the link says. And we call the DDC, we speak to an engineer, and he says he can't really give us any more information because they don't really know. The only good thing is that the engineer doesn't pretend, whereas Desiree, the woman from the PR firm for the DDC, has to pretend. That is her job. I asked her where she lives at an earlier board meeting, and she ignored me and seemed threatened. I only wanted to say you don't live here, and this is not your life, this is your job. When we talked about the particulate matter that will blow from the million tons of landfill that will bury our park once they begin, she said they would put some water on it so it doesn't blow around. Or they might get some tarps. Finally, though, her best advice was, we can close our windows. Yeah, I remember that after 9/11, keeping my window closed. And 9/11, if you remember, wasn't a plan. It wasn't our plan anyway. It wasn't a choice. Esker is a choice on the part of our city government, but you can't call this planning. We thought since there's been a pandemic, since they came up with Esker and most recently flooding, that there ought to be an oversight hearing on their plan. Since 2019, when Esker was first foisted on a neighborhood that does not want it, drop it, please. Thank you. We have been told the rationale was the value engineering report. We said, let us see it. They said, no. The engineering firm that was commissioned by Carlina Rivera and Gail Brewer to compare the original plan vetted by the community in some mid-step plan and the plan of doing nothing and the newer, faster, more destructive, more expensive Esker asked to see the value engineering report, and the city said no. Before the commission delivered its report, the city council, including Carlina Rivera, who had commissioned the as-yet incomplete study, voted almost unanimously to go ahead with the newer, faster, more expensive, more destructive plan, despite community outrage and environmentalist testimony against the plan. We continued to ask them to see the report, and the city said it didn't exist. Carlina said there never was a report. It was more like a workshop. Finally, we received an utterly redacted plan. We foiled for the original document. We received a less redacted plan. What are they hiding, huh? But what do we want? But in the middle of all this mishigas, what do we want? A member of our IRPA group, that's East River Park Action, was on her way to the climate conference in Glasgow. Wendy Brower writes this. To tell the truth, said one of the chief negotiators for the UN climate agreement, and the whole audience wept along with her, knowing that without, to tell the truth, that's the plan. And the whole audience wept along with her, knowing that without a fundamental realignment of values, policies, and practices, our species cannot survive the soaring temperatures, emissions, displacements, and injustices that we are already experiencing. Back to Wendy. The whole world is coming together to remove carbon and mitigate impacts, yet the current Esker is carbon intensive and sacrifices our community when a better plan can protect NYCHA, other housing, and East River Park against many of the different kinds of climate shocks, including extreme rainfall, overheating, drought, not just the Esker's sea level rise and storm surge protection. And after repeated foils, we did get the majority of the value engineering report. And here's the shocking news about why we desperately need an oversight hearing before they go ahead with this madness. This is what's in the report. There was not one climate scientist, health or environmental professional at the table during the selection of the current destructive plan, according to the value engineering report. The environmental impact statement referred to in it left out current climate data, environmental justice, the pandemic, the newly announced wrapping of the Con Ed lines, which were one of the reasons why they had to do this plan. With much of this already known or intuited, we began a large protest march last April to petition Justin Brannan, City Council Chair of the Waterfront and Resiliency Committee, to call an oversight hearing for the City Council. After almost 3 months, Brannan agreed to have a meeting with us in his office. He agreed to hold an oversight hearing, subsequently pulling in the support of James Gennaro, Environmental Chair of the City Council. The next hurdle was Corey Johnson, the Speaker of the City Council. Corey apparently needed to approve the hearing, and from then, the end of June, until today, he has not responded. We began petitioning Corey by mail and by phoning his office. We hung a huge banner outside City Hall demanding he respond, and two women attached themselves to a tree. Nothing. We returned the following week and occupied a small area of City Park Hall Park with a succession of people chained to trees. Chelsea Manning, as well as a shifting and dedicated throng, showed up for days. And lo, avoiding the cab drivers who were striking at the other entrance to City Hall, Corey Johnson appeared. He told us in a congenial 25-minute conversation that he had never heard of Esker. Meanwhile, he was the Speaker of the City Council when they voted on it. He had never heard of Esker, and he knew nothing about the destruction of East River Park. He had received none of our messages, and Justin Brannan had never written him. He gave us his contact, and he asked for more information. He claimed that Carlina Rivera and Keith Powers and Margaret Chin, as the councilors whose district Esker affects, would need to petition for the hearing. Later, we have been told that was not true. In fact, Carlina Rivera told us at one of her events in Stuytown that Corey told her that the request would have to come from the appropriate committee, i.e. Justin Brannan. We have been inviting Justin Brannan to come here and meet with us here today and all the days we have been down here. We told him Corey Johnson said he never asked for a hearing. He said he would put it in writing and send it to us. He has not. We called him and asked for it. We sent Corey Johnson all the information he could possibly want. We've asked for a meeting, we've asked for a reply, we invited him to be here today. The City Council feels like a comedy team that keeps passing a hot potato while each saying, I don't have the potato. But the hot potato is our lives, our health, our environment, and the young people who have never had any voice, like that thing that Tommy was talking about, the meeting he's going to at 4 o'clock. There's no young people on that meeting. There's nobody young. So the young people who never had any voice in this process and will be holding the bag when this park is gone, when I am gone. And as Catherine de la Cruz, a young artist and activist who has been showing up and organizing, speaking for our cause, said, after they kill these ones, meaning the trees, the old trees, I don't know if there will be any more 90-year-old trees, which is, to me, the most profound question of what we're going through. How can you possibly cut down 80-year-old trees when you don't have any guarantee on this planet that there will ever be another 80 or 90-year-old tree? That is the greatest question I've heard. Why would there be a future anyone can believe in, since we are still living in a legacy of mired in deception and opportunism and dysfunction in the present day? Is it possible the DDC knows so little about what itself is doing, except that they want to break ground on Esker and get the destruction going, and they will mop up later and give us a plastic rendition of a public park. A plastic rendition of democracy, because that is what we are living in today. Our government is a joke. Our participatory process is a joke. I mean, I really have, increasingly, that people who don't vote, I think, I feel that in a deep way. It was like, who are you? The destruction of the planet and our lives is not a joke, and there will be no one left holding the bag. That hot potato in the city of New York and de Blasio and all these characters apparently protecting their own political futures by pushing us all to the end of global extinction. If they can do it here in plain sight, and that's the scariest part too, is they keep saying, the people who want to do it say, this will be a model for the world. Can you imagine what that means? I mean, if they can do it here in plain sight with no faint recognition in the mainstream media, I mean, like, we're standing here right now, we call the press conference. Is there any media here at all? Is there any mainstream media? Would they ever come? I mean, I can't help feeling like this is the biggest real estate deal of the 21st century. That's what we're really talking about. 60 acres of riverfront land. Look at the west side and look at the east side. That's what we're talking about. every goddamn bit of media in New York City and every goddamn politician is in on this, or else tell me what else it could possibly be. Is this just dysfunction driven so up the ass of democracy that we're all gonna die of it? They can do it here in plain sight with no faint recognition in the mainstream media that this is happening. If you can make it here, they can make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York, New York.
Thank you.
So, Makes Galazio's